Hi, I'm Mike with House on the Mend, and in episode 6 of our ongoing series rehabbing this house in Blvd City, Arizona, we're going to be painting doors with the help of these Saker paint racks, designed to help you easily flip the doors and paint both sides, and then stack them to dry. So let's get started.
If you break it, we'll fix it. If you buy it, we'll build it. House on the Mend.
Now, full disclosure, I am not paid nor sponsored by Saker. They did reach out to me and sent me 12 of these racks. That's enough for 3 doors for me to review. So let's unbox them and see what's inside. All right, let's see what's in the box. You get a bag of screws. There are 2 different size screws. There's this little one and then this bigger set of screws. So that's nice that you get a choice. Very small set of instructions. And then in 2 different bags are the 4 accessory tools here. All right. I see, first of all, this honeycomb design makes them really rigid, which I like. They're also very lightweight, so super portable. You see this keyhole here? That corresponds to the notch on the other end so that they stack up and hold true. This side here that attaches against a door, and this circular part right here, it's kind of hard to see, but it sticks out very slightly right there. And that's so when it's against the door and you're pivoting the door to paint the other side or moving it, that it's not scratching along the door. So that's nice. And then this side here, the front, do you see this notch right here? That is if you want to set a door on its side and screw it in and hold it in place and then paint both sides. Now, one thing I will note here is that this is a full thickness exterior door. So your standard interior door is going to be kind of racking back and forth and unstable on that. So the screw hole stands at about 2¾ inches. So when I attach my doors, I'm going to go in from either side 2 inches. And that way, as the door pivots when I'm painting the other side, I won't be knocking the door on whatever surface that is below it. And I think that'll work out nice. And it's still in quite a ways from the end, so I don't have to worry about any wood splitting on the doors.
I typically use a nail set to get underneath the hinge pin and knock it with a hammer. But Ryobi makes this really cool tool designed specifically with this little rod here to slide right up into place and remove that hinge pin. And if it's still too tight to pull out, once you get it there, then you rotate it and there's this piece that'll catch and you can knock it out the rest of the way until it's free to remove. Pretty slick.
To keep track of the doors, I mark them on the top. For example, MC stands for Master Bedroom Closet. And that way, when you're done painting in batch, you'll be able to quickly determine which door goes where. Well, these standard sawhorses that you can buy at any home improvement store are 32 inches long. And the nice thing about these Saker paint racks is that their footprint is not very big, and therefore these standard size doors, this is a 30 inch door, and then we also have 28 inch doors And then there's a size smaller and a size bigger, but basically your most common doors, your 28 or your 30 inch doors, will easily fit on a sawhorse if you, like me, like to work elevated instead of bending over and painting down by your feet. Before painting, make sure that we wipe everything down with a microfiber towel. All right, I have three doors set up with the Saker racks, two over there and this one here that I have up on sawhorses. I have three other doors set up with the Saker competitor, but we'll talk more about that later. Let's first focus on the functionality of why we're here to review the Saker racks. I'm gonna paint one side and then let's try flipping it over and see how functional that is on the sawhorse or if we'd be better off just doing it on the ground. I have a paint suit on from when I painted the interior because I was getting stuff falling down on me. I don't think that's completely necessary, but I don't want to be all full of paint dust. And of course, I have a respirator. All right, let's give it a try. That looks good. Let me turn this around so it doesn't impede my microphone. Now, if your door is pre-drilled with the hole, you'll be able to just simply pick it up and flip it over on the ground. Let's see what that's like here on a sawhorse. So the hole is not in the center of the door, so it's going to be a little lopsided that way. But if I pick it up and kind of support the weight and I bring it to this side, rotate it down. Yep, that works great. Awesome, let's get this side. All right, I'm paying real close attention to the spots where the paint racks are to see if they're impeding the paint right there. And not at all, it looks great. All right, I'm gonna take this one down. I'm gonna set it over here and get the next one going. I'd say the Saker's number one competition online would be the Stak rack. So how do these two stack up against each other, to pardon the pun? First of all, the price is exactly the same. A set of 12, which will do three doors, is $79.99. Secondly, the packaging, far superior for the Saker. As you can see here, the Stak rack came in nothing but cellophane that was obliterated during shipping, and all the screws were all over the box and I had to find them all. They didn't even come in a bag like this. Speaking of screws, you get one size screw with the Stak rack, and as we already covered, you get the same amount of screws in two different sizes for the Saker, so hats off to the Saker. Both units have the keyhole to help them stack up right here and right here. When the Stak rack is stacked on top of each other, they are very stable. However, when they're connected to doors, it's not going to be a big difference. You'll see these little teeth sticking up, one on each side of the Stak rack. Those are meant for crown molding, baseboard, or door casing to stack on, and then you can dry them that way. My only worry about that is, I would say over time, as you're stacking things on here, it's gonna get a little wobbly. And then as long as whatever you are trying to dry is not more than 5 inches, you'll be fine, but you are limited to that once you stack another Stak rack on top of it. As we previously covered with the Sakers, they have one notch to hold a door rigid, and that is for an exterior size door. Whereas with the Stak rack, you have two sets of notches on the top and the bottom that can hold an interior or an exterior sized door. And one last difference I've noticed between the two is the Saker screw hole is dead center of the unit. And therefore, no matter what spot you put it in, it just wants to stay right there because it's perfectly balanced. Whereas the stack rack is purposely unbalanced, meaning that the screw hole is way up top. So it always wants to find the base pointing down. So at whatever point you are rotating a door back and forth, it always wants the feet to be down so you can easily stack onto the previous unit or easily stack onto the ground. Now, when it comes time for painting and drying baseboard, door casing, crown molding, rather than stacking one piece on this little tooth, I think a better method would be to create drying racks with either kit that you purchase. Now, you can use 2x4s, you can use 2x2s, or in this case, I have a closet rod left over, and I cut it into short lengths for this demonstration. But as you can see here, you can do several racks where you set your material down to dry, and then when it comes time to stack them to save space, you can use the same method as you do with the doors. And so for that reason, this little gimmick here doesn't really impress me. So when it comes time to move the doors, if they're not fully dry, I have found the easiest thing to do is to put one hand in the hole that's pre-drilled for the handle and then control the door with one side of the racks. And that will keep it nice and steady. All right, let's paint some shelves. I have the racks on the sides of the shelves. I couldn't fit all of them on my sawhorses here, so we'll do three and then this one. But we'll be able to paint them and then turn them and paint the other side, and they'll be able to dry and stack up to get out of the way. And there we go. Well, I'm glad we got all the painting we needed done because it is approaching 120 degrees in this sunroom and I'm afraid my camera's gonna overheat again. So let's finish up. I think these Saker paint racks are very functional, very versatile, and very easy to use. I had no problem flipping them over and moving the doors with these on. I thought they were just as functional as they other racks that we tested simultaneously during this project. So I would have absolutely no problem recommending them to you for professional or DIY use. Now let's talk about the cost. So $79.99 divided by 12 is $6.66 each. Not only is that the mark of the beast, hello, but I think that's a bit pricey for a piece of plastic and a screw. Now, the other set of racks are the exact same price. But I think you should check back periodically on Amazon and wait for a sale. Now, if you found this video helpful, will you please give it a thumbs up? It really helps the YouTube algorithm to start suggesting it to more people like you. Also, please consider subscribing. I work really hard to put out good quality content, and there's more videos to come. I'm going to leave a link for these paint racks in the description below. Full disclosure, those are Amazon affiliate links. So if you click on them and end up making a purchase, it won't cost you a thing, but I do get a small reward at the end of the month that helps to justify the time it takes to make these videos. Until next time, thank you for watching.